Today's topic, India's rising terrorism and seditious activism. Hello friends, last I told you about our vulnerable economy, which has nothing promising for the mammoth force of impoverished and illiterate or demi-literate force of people who are likely to remain in the same predicament in which they are now. Dependent on government charities and relief programs, devoid of liberty and dignity. Today I will tell you our disintegrating fraternity and integrity. Friends, unrest, perversive threats and divisive activism are the conspicuous culmination of people's oppression, neglect and unfulfilled human rights. Such kinds of activism are a serious threat to our internal peace and tranquility. Terrorism and violism are on the rise. Maoism, Naxalism, terrorism and seditious activism, according to my analysis, is a culmination of revolt against consistent underdevelopment and paucity of means of livelihood. Apparently, the situation had risen out of perennial lack of fulfilling fiduciary obligations of the governments for the people of the region. The people are imbued with a strong conviction that their guardians and governments are insensitive to their miseries. It is not cajoling to bring them to the discussion table, but development, that is the need of the hour. Without creating tangible and lasting means of livelihood and assuring them of unflagging care in future, there is little to discuss. The situation of the nation is indeed volcanic and getting grimmer with each passing day. Even the then Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh expressed a similar opinion on 4th November 2004. Naxalism is the single biggest internal security challenge India has faced. By 2010, the Naxals and Maoists had spread over to at least 15 states and 233 districts, 37.2% of a total of 625 districts of India, and aim at liberalizing India by 2050. As the sufferings of the people are growing, so also are their rebellions and aversion for the law. Partition thoughts and withering brotherhood, fratricidal instincts culminate in the polarization of the nation. It is a dangerous indicator of communal divides and fragmentation of the nation. The Tendulkar and N.C. Saxena committee reports on the miseries of the people have further underlined the pathetic condition of our people. The plight of our tribal areas and that of interior India may be more harrowing than meets the eye, evoking little surprise at the rising Maoism, Naxalism and other terrorist activity in the country. The tragic and barbaric massacre of 24 Congress leaders and workers on 25th May 2013 by Naxalite in Bastar, Chhattisgarh, is indicative of deteriorating plight of the tribal people. This is rebellion in the making. The Mumbai terror attack, 26 November 2008, killings, kidnappings, rapes, train lootings, murders, suicides, serial blasts, and unnatural deaths have become regular events and are increasing. The whole nation is simmering in July-August 2012 riots erupted in Assam. About 80 people died and 4 lakh took refuge in relief camps. And political parties gave different versions. It too was a culmination of economic regression and frustration flared up by vote politics. Proliferation of the terrorist activities and their outfits are no different than the recent turmoil and civil wars in Egypt, Syria, Libya and other nations, as briefly discussed in the book, that flared up to the shape of a civil war by 2014-15. Causes of our unrest and frustration are similar. At least 30,000 fled from Bangalore alone, besides many thousands from Mumbai, Hyderabad, Chennai, Pune, etc. In protest against communal hatred, Muslim leaders in Mumbai took out a huge rally and attacked media persons. It was followed by Raj Thackeray at another huge rally, spewing venom. Outsiders not permitted in his state. It shows people are disgruntled and restless with their sufferings, and a rebellion is in the making. Rising unemployment results in large-scale distress migration of people from backward areas to urban areas. There are voices of dissent demanding freedom, such as Kashmir and the Northeast states, or division of existing states. Tamil Nadu for the most backward Vanyar community, Uttar Pradesh for Bundelkhand, and now Mayawati, chief of Bahujan Samaj Party, BSP, wants the state to be divided into four separate states, West Bengal for Darjeeling, and consequently Gorkhaland, Meghalaya for Goroland, Andhra Pradesh for Telangana. Telangana since officially become the 29th state of the country on 2nd June 2014. If new states keep on adding in this manner, the political parties may remain engaged around the year in organizing election campaigns and other election activities. Even now we feel as if elections are happening around the year. The common man too engages in speculations and discussing politics, while the development of the nation and welfare of the people occupy the back seat. To address this problem, the only solution is welfare of the people and adequate job opportunities. Friends, this was for today. Please give a serious thought to what I have said. Next, I will tell you more on the making of the rebellion. Till then, goodbye and thank you.